Should the Quran be recited to deal with mental health issues? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the Quran in different ways. And one of the descriptions of the Quran is that it is a shifa. It is a cure, it is a healing. And we learn from the Sunnah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged people to recite the Quran for healing purposes. Meaning even when they were suffering from some physical ailment, he encouraged them to recite the Quran for the purpose of shifa. We learned that once a group of companions were traveling somewhere, and as they camped at a certain place, the local people over there, someone got bitten by a poisonous creature. And so they asked them that, is there anyone among you, a doctor, someone who can help? So one of the companions went and he recited Suratul Fatiha over and over again until the person was feeling better. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam approved of this action. We learned that at another occasion, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Alijiha bi kitabillah," that treat her with the book of Allah. Meaning for physical illnesses also, we should recite the Quran. So when it comes to mental health issues also, remember that the Quran heals. It is healing. So the Quran should be recited for the illnesses of the body as well as the illnesses of the mind, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the Quran as a shifa. We learn that Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says that leaving the Quran, abandoning the Quran, is to abandon believing in it, to abandon reciting it, to abandon contemplating on it, to abandon acting upon it, and also to abandon seeking cure through it. So part of our duty to the Quran is that we use it for treatment also. So when we are physically unwell, yes, we go to the doctor, and yes, we get the medication, and we recite the Quran. Likewise, when we're struggling with mental health issues, again, we go to the doctor, we take the medication, we go for therapy, and we also recite the Quran. So shifa is obtained by using both of these methods, by using the Quran and by also using medication and other things.
Hey, thank you for watching, and subscribe so you can continue to get the rest of the videos. I don't know, whether somewhere over here, there, whatever, whatnot. It's beautiful, this series of videos, FaithIQ, and we need your support. And that's by watching it, by sharing it, and then by donating towards it so we can continue to make more videos that deal with more of your issues. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.